Converting audio to MIDI is a fantastic feature that you can use right here in Logic Pro. Now, the results are going to vary depending on the type of material that you're recording. However, I'm going to show you exactly how you can accomplish this. So let's get into it. Now, unlike converting MIDI to audio, which is really simple, all you need to do is select your MIDI region like so, right click, bounce in place, set your parameters here, boom, there we go. This is very simple. However, the other way around, audio to MIDI is a bit more of a complex proposition, which means Logic has to do a great deal of analysis in order to get this thing right. So I've got a few examples of different instruments which are in audio format right here, and we're going to quickly experiment to see what results we get for each one. Now, I need to make this really clear at the outset. This process works best with solo instruments playing a single melody. So soloing on a keyboard rather than chords, or if you're looking to convert a guitar part, a guitar solo rather than strumming chords. Okay, so let's start off with this saxophone part. So let's have a listen. Lovely. So to convert this audio to MIDI, what we need to do first is come up here to the flex button and click on that. And now we're going to choose flex pitch. And as you can see here, we've got some blobs which represent the pitch information in this actual region. We're going to press E on our MIDI keyboard to go into the audio editor. We're going to click track just here. And we're going to make sure the flex button is selected over here. Now, right here, we can see all of the pitch information. Come over to edit, then choose create MIDI track from flex pitch data. And as you can see, a new MIDI region has been created. Now let's have a listen to check out what the results are like. So let's start with the original part first. Now for the converted part, I'm using a grand piano sound. Not bad at all. There are a few things I'll need to go in and adjust. So let's just go back. Right, so there are a few notes up here that need to be pitched down. Let's grab these, use the key command, shift, option, and then down arrow. Okay, that's a lot better. There's a couple of bits that need to be tidied up, but we've pretty much captured that sax melody. All right, let's move on to the next one. This time it's an electric bass. Let's have a quick listen. Okay, same principle. Make sure we've got the flex button switched on. Come over to the bass channel. Choose flex pitch. All of the pitch information, once again, we're going to press E on our keyboard. We're in track view with flex on. Come to edit, create MIDI track from flex pitch data. Now here is our converted bass. I'm going to increase the velocity of these notes. Once again, I'm using a grand piano to play back this part. So let's have a quick listen. Not that great. Compared to the sax part, I don't think it's done an excellent job. Of course, we can go in and we can edit the notes and try and come up with a more accurate representation of the original, but I'm not that sure. Let's try another instrument and see how well we do there. So this time, let's see how well it works on this vocal passage. I've grabbed the vocal sample from Splice. Let's have a listen to it.
No, nothing ever really changes. Just power down and start again.
Okay, so we're in flex mode, flex pitch right here, and now the audio editor, edit, create MIDI from flex pitch data. This time I'll use an electric piano. Let's have a listen. Again, not that great, to be honest with you. Compared to what was achieved with a saxophone part, this is pretty disappointing. However, I reckon if I had a different vocal sample, maybe we'd have gotten some better results. So in effect, if I was to rank all of these results, I'd say the sax was the best. Then maybe the electric bass And then, of course, the vocal results will be the poorest. However, there's one more thing I want to show you in terms of converting audio to MIDI. So let's do that now. This time I want to show you how you can convert drum tracks from audio to MIDI. Now, I have got a dedicated video specifically on this, which goes into far more detail. But for now, let me just do a really quick example. So here's the drum part that we want to convert. It's just four bars and there are only two different drums in there, the kick and a snare kind of side stick sound. Have a listen. Okay, so to achieve this, what we want to do is select the part, come up to track, and then come down to replace or double drum track. Or you can use the key command Control D. Now, instantly we get three things on screen. First of all, we have a MIDI region that wasn't there before. We then have this control panel right here. And over here in the library, we've got a selection of different sounds or samples. Now, right here, I can determine which instrument I want to export as MIDI, kick, snare, tom, or other. As I said, we've got two sounds in this part. But for now, we're going to stick to kick and we're just going to click OK. Let's mute the original audio and have a listen. So that has converted all of the notes. Now, all I need to do is come in here and figure out where the snare or rim might be hitting. Now, if we were to count four beats in a bar, I know that a snare hits on beat two and beat four. So all I need to do is delete that and delete this. And then do the same here and the same here. I can then do the same for the rest of the bar. Next thing I can do is come over here to the samples that Logic has thrown up, which I can use for this part, or I can pull in my own drum samples. Let's switch out the sample. Or this one. Okay, cool. So you get the principle. So let's go back and do the same thing, but this time we're going to isolate the snare or rim shot hits. So once again, we select our drum part, we come up to track, then we come down to replace or double drum track. And I'm going to click snare and click OK. And this time Logic will provide me with some snare sounds. And like before, when we open up the MIDI region, we should hear all of the notes. But we know that the side stick hits on beats two and four in every bar. So all I need to do is select that one, which is on beat two, and hold down the shift key, click that one on beat four, and then come over to here, beat two and beat four, beat two, beat four, and finally beat two and beat four. Come to edit, select, invert selection, or use the key command Shift I, then hit delete, and I'll be left with the notes I've selected. Now, if I play back, once again, I can assign my own samples to this MIDI part, maybe using the Quick Sampler. Check out my video on using the Quick Sampler in Logic Pro. And that's that, really. However, I believe very soon things are going to improve dramatically with the increase of AI technologies being incorporated into digital audio workstations and other such tools. We'll be able to get far better and more accurate audio to MIDI conversion in the very near future. Now, remember, if I brought you value, do me a favor and hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already done so, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. I'm Deuce, I'm out. Peace.